Nation.
I'm Rylee.
And I'm Brandon, and welcome to the fifth show of OWTV this season.
To recap sports last week, we had a soccer game against Shawnee Mission East on Tuesday, then a second soccer game against Olathe North on Thursday.
Friday, we had a football game against Olathe East.
Speaking of football, make sure to pack the stands at our last home game, Thursday, October 19th, against Shawnee Mission South. Our seniors will be highlighted for all their hard work.
Our boys and girls cross-country teams are having a great season this year.
Our boys team is ranked third in the state, and our girls team is killing it as they are ranked first in the state and 30th in the nation.
Let's take it to Lance as he met with some of the cross-country runners and asked them some questions about their season.
My name is Kate Miller, and I'm a senior.
What would you say the culture is like for the girls' cross-country team?
I would definitely say we have a very fun culture. It's a very, like, hardworking, but also we know how to, like, have a good time when we're working hard. And I would say that we all are very, like, bonded. We're more like friends and we're like teammates. And so it makes, like, the hard days easier when you have, like, your friends with you and just, like, enjoying doing those hard things together and making each other better.
My name is Gunnar Hornung, and I am a junior.
And when did you start running cross country?
I started my freshman year right after cross country season ended.
What would you say, I mean, obviously there's been a change, you know, at least on the success-wise, what would you say was the major change between your freshman year and now that you're projected to be one of the top teams in the state?
Like, as we saw that, like, we were getting better and we had a chance to, like, place well, everybody, like, really, like, they saw the goal and so they started trying harder to achieve it.
What is your favorite memory of cross-country from, like, all your years?
Dude, there's so many. There's so many good ones. We have a camp we do over the summer in Iowa. That's always really fun. Just some of my favorite memories have been there. Met a lot of great friends.
What would you say the culture was like when you got here in freshman year?
When I got here my freshman year, the culture was a lot less serious. It was a lot more on just, like, having fun at practice and messing around.
What would you say is one major change you've seen since that?
I think it's just it's the mindset in the team in terms of, like, consistency and showing up to practice.
And then what is it like, going to a meet knowing that you have three state titles?
Yeah, it's really exciting to, like, win the state titles and, like, going to meets. Like, now we know that, like, people look at us and they're like, okay, they're really good. We just have to keep, like, pushing and working hard no matter what.
You still have three chances to catch our cross-country team out running the competition on the following dates. Wait, Brandon, what are you doing?
Dang, Rylee, you really got to blame spot the imposter. Let's see if students and staff do a better job at hiding than I did.
Hey guys, it's Amberleigh. Today we are going to be introducing a brand new segment called Spot the Imposter. We have Jen, we have Mr. Showalter, we have Lauren Grimes, and we have Miss Clark.
As it was, we know it's not the same. Lauren, because I was trying to copy you, and yours dancing wasn't matching mine.
I'm going, hug me, what's bring it in.
Oh,
the
one from just
like,
too. I don't know what that song was. Right. Like. I don't know what it's called.
Peace! Congratulations to the winners. I can't wait to see more.
Hey Brandon, did you go to Dig Pink this past Monday?
No, I didn't. What's that?
All Olathe schools, volleyball teams, coaches, and fans gathered to spread awareness for breast cancer. This year, it was at Olathe East. Thank you to all who showed up and showed support.
We would also like to congratulate Rylee Orth for hitting 1,000 digs in her high school career. Rylee, did you know our very own Bryn Stoll was selected to represent Team Kansas at the Metro Sports MOCAN volleyball game?
Wow, what does that mean?
Good thing Cami and Maya sat down with her to ask her a few questions.
How long have you been playing volleyball?
I've been playing rec since I was probably 8, and then I started club when I was in 5th grade.
How has volleyball affected you as a person?
It's given me an, like, thing about myself. I have, it's just a lot of my personality. I do it a lot. I spend a lot of time in the gym with my teammates, so no, it just is like kind of my identity, and I do a lot of things that have to do with it, so yeah.
What is the Metro Sports MOCAN volleyball game?
It's a volleyball game against a Kansas team and a Missouri team, and then the top 14 players from each side of the state, so top 14 Kansas players and then top 14 Missouri players, are all picked, and then they'll play against each other in a match that's going to be sometime in November, I think. So,
what does it mean to you to have been picked?
It means a lot, just because I've worked really, really hard to like kind of make it known just how much work I've put into the sport and how much improvement I've seen. Getting picked definitely was like a big confidence boost, because I'm the only Division II commit that was selected. So just kind of like making a name for myself and like actually like proving that I can hang with like the top.
Congratulations, Bryn.
Bryn and the rest of our volleyball team have been really busy lately. They also compete against the football team in our new game, Sport Swap.
Let's take a look.
Starters versus the Buff Puff champs. First to 7 wins. Standing wins. And your winner is team football.
I bet Fat Tay needed a break after that one.
I think we all need a break.
That's good, because we have a short week next week. Wednesday the 18th is ACT testing day. Students report to your AI classrooms by 7:45. The test starts at 8 o'clock. Make sure to be well-rested with your student ID in hand and have a good breakfast beforehand. Don't stress, it's just practice. Try your best to prepare yourself for the real test.
If juniors and seniors are interested in applying to National Honor Society, make sure to turn in your applications by October 17th. Ask Ms. Boyd or Ms. Clark for more details, or visit the NHS website to find any additional information.
NHS is hosting Trunk or Treat on October 29th from 1 o'clock to 3 o'clock. Let all your friends and family know to show out and support Olathe West National Honor Society. Make sure to show out in all your pink to the soccer game tonight at Seabeck against our rivals, Olathe Northwest.
Hey, don't forget about the football game, too. Wear all your neon. It's at Seabeck at 7 p.m. on Friday. Be there and be loud. Don't forget, Olathe West Feminist Club is hosting a hygiene drive to bring awareness to domestic violence October 23rd through October 28th before school and during lunch.
And that's it for this week's episode of OWTV.
Wait, Brandon, we have one more thing to show them.
Oh, yeah, Rylee, you're right. We'll leave you with this teaser for our next show. See ya, owls.
Hey, I'm Nior. I'm from France.
I'm Sven. I'm from Sweden. And I'm Theo, and I'm from Norway. We're tasting American candy. I mean, it's good.
I don't like it.
I like it.
I like it too.
This has that like American synthetic feel after.
Kind of.
Just sugar.
True. Tear it from over these.